and welcome back to another episode of The Muscle Whisperer with me, Kate Browne. In this episode, we'll be looking at bony landmarks of the scapula. So I hope you enjoy. If you have any comments, please leave them below.
Okay, so we are scrubbing up on a bit of anatomy today and looking at the scapula. So obviously, as therapists, we work with the shoulder bones a lot, and just understanding where the bony landmarks are and what they're called and what they relate to can really improve your understanding of what you're doing in a treatment and why you're doing it. So the easiest landmark to find is the spine of the scapula. So that's this horizontal line coming across at the top of the scapula. It's really easy to palpate. You can just feel using your fingertips that there is a bony prominence, and that just comes all the way across the top of the back there, and you can follow it out to the top of the arm as well, where it becomes the acromion. So nice and easy, the spine of the scapula, you'll be able to palpate that with your fingertips and follow it horizontally. So this leads us round to the acromion, which is the outermost part of the arm and of the shoulder. So attaching to the acromion, we have the trapezius, which comes down from above. And then from below, we have the deltoid. They both also connect along the outer third of the clavicle, and also the same for the spine of the scapula. And they actually mirror each other, the fibres of the trapezius and the deltoid, so they meet exactly where the other one does all the way along, which can help find one or the other. So then above the spine of the scapula is the supraspinatus fossa. And that's where the supraspinatus muscle lies. So again, that's really easy to find. All you have to do is find the spine of the scapula and then just come above it. You'll find that squidgy part, which is the supraspinatus muscle. Then as we come around laterally, we've got the infraglenoid tubercle, which is just a really small tubercle here. And that is where the long head of the triceps attaches. Just to be aware, that is here. Then as we come down the lateral border attaching here, we have things like teres minor, teres major. In the middle here, we've got the infraspinous fossa, which is where the infraspinatus muscle sits. This is a real tongue twister. So that's where the belly of that muscle lies, in this sort of concave area here. At the bottom, and this is known as the inferior medial angle, latissimus dorsi just attaches across here. And then in opposition at the top, so we've got the inferior medial angle, and at the top we've got the superior medial angle. And up here we've got the levator scapulae muscle that attaches just at this upper medial portion of the scapula and comes up the neck like that. Down the medial border, we've got the rhomboids that attach. They come across to the spine like this. And yeah, I think that mostly sums it up. So when you're trying to find the superior medial angle, again, the best thing is actually to find the spine of the scapula first and walk your fingers along from that. And then you know that just above here, probably one or two finger widths, then you've got the superior medial angle just above it. And then if you want to find the inferior medial angle, the easiest way that I'm sure most of you use a lot anyway is to put the arm behind the back, and that just retracts the shoulder blade so that you can see the edges more clearly. So you can just palpate and find, and that's that's the bottom part. So I hope that was helpful to you, maybe learn a thing or two. Let me know in the comments below if there's any areas that you want me to demonstrate and paint and show you. Body painting is such a good way of learning anatomy. I'll be running some body paint anatomy workshops where we look primarily at muscle anatomy, and we've got some of those coming up, one in Bristol or two in Bristol and one in Exeter. So do get in touch if you want to learn more about those.
If you enjoyed today's video, then please like, share and subscribe. We look forward to seeing you again soon.